morning, everybody. Jimmy with two of the top crane here. Today's going to be a little bit different. And this, I mean, this past week's been full of different stuff. We're driving about 85 miles north up into the edge of Iowa. And picking up a grain bin. Yeah, like an entire grain bin. It's already built. It's been there for years. I guess it's 35 feet in diameter, 40 or 50 feet tall. Sitting on a concrete pad, and they want to move it to another concrete pad about 75 feet away. I guess they're kind of in floodplain. They're wanting to build a berm or something and keep stuff out of there, keep the water out of their bins. I don't know what the situation is. I just know we got to move it. Destination. This used to be a highway. This was V Highway just west of Hamburg, Iowa. And the floods last year took it out. So they're in here even still a year later trying to get all this rebuilt. Pulling dirt out of fields, trying to rebuild levees. Once they get all that done, I'm sure they'll bring a paving crew in, put this dirt road back into a highway again. I'll try to record some footage heading out of here and show you guys the asphalt road that has been just ripped apart that we had to drive over. It's amazing the power of water, but it just scoured the top surface of the asphalt off. Well, back there it did. Up here, it kind of took the road completely out in places. But it does look like some of the farmers have gotten some crop in this year, which is pretty amazing considering the hand they were dealt last year. But anyway, one of those big grain bins up there, the one closest to the road towards us, is the one we're picking up, as far as I know. It's about 40 or 50 feet tall and about 35 feet in diameter. I guess we're going to pick it up and move it. So, anyway, ought to make for some interesting footage. But I'm going to meander on down here. We're going to dump our boom dolly off and talk to some people, see what exactly has to happen. Get the crane set up with full counterweights and get ready to do this thing. Okay, we're on this bin site. We just got all set up. Got 110,000 pounds of counterweight, 114 feet of boom, four parts of line. We're going to drop our block down through the top of this bin. They've got rigging runs clear to the bottom. And when we pick up on that rigging, our block should just be sticking out the top of the bin. I guess they got 60 foot chokers down there in the bottom of it. Okay, so on this screen, this is the weight on the rear outriggers. This is the weight on the front outriggers. This shows how level we are. Fuel, tack, water temperature. Shows my axles are locked in the up position. And if you watch these numbers, you'll be able to see the weight transfer from the front outriggers to the back outriggers as we increase the load on the end of the boom. So on this screen, this is the driver's side front outrigger, driver's side rear, passenger side front, passenger side rear. Yeah, they're all coming out of there, so we'll see. I'm guessing we're getting pretty close to picking it. Alright, here we go. Here I got 12,000 on it. Oh, that rigger shifted a little bit. It happens. For a second, he wants to go look at it. So we're holding it with 30,800 on it. Got 105 tons on my passenger side rear outrigger, 81 tons on my driver's side rear, 26 on the passenger side front, 35 on the driver's side front. I guess I'll pan this down, this other camera. Down here where you guys can see what's going on. about 30,000 on it. 30,600 total.
Everything looks good back there, so I just heard that booming and stuff.
And yeah, I'm sure it just shifted a little bit. Is all the way up?
Close to having it. I mean, what do you got?
About 30,000.
Okay. So yeah, you're really close, all but just it's sitting still on one spot. But
you mean go ahead and come up with it?
Yeah, I looked inside. Everything looked good. Right.
Okay. Cable up a little bit more. Is it on that other side?
It's about the same.
Okay.
You probably just need to come up.
Yeah, I'm just booming up and cabling
about
down.
About 6 inches higher is about where you need to be.
Okay.
You've got an auger inside, you got to clear.
Okay.
And yeah, you can just boom up and cable down at that point. You're plenty high.
Thing I've lifted with this crane, but this is probably physically the biggest. I mean, it's not too often you get to move a grain bin. outrigger pretty heavy once we go setting it down. Of course, it should sit a little closer. Can we come off of it?
Yeah, we'll unhook you and we're done.
Okay. Alright, we're gonna come off of it. You guys should see a bunch of weight come off of this one outrigger over there. Thank you. top, signal me so they can cut me loose. Then we'll be tearing down and heading back. 2.5 hour drive home. All right, let's see if I can get a little bit of this footage of this road. And we got a tractor coming at us with, I'm guessing, a pan on the back. I'm hoping he's pulling off before I get to him. If he's not, he's going to. I'm guessing he's going to turn left there. They say gross vehicle weight wins. It's a toss-up at this point, I would say, between these two. State Highway.